start in Shavasana. So go ahead and come down onto your backs. This is kind of like the alpha and the omega. It's always a bit of a treat when you start on your back. Find the back of your body in contact with the floor. Back in your head, your arms, back, shoulders, glutes, hamstrings, calves, heels. Feel the earth supporting you. Take three deep breaths. Fully in the space, in the present moment. Thank yourself for showing up. At this time, you may set an intention for your practice. Something you hope to dedicate your work to. This will be a goddess-inspired flow. So maybe think about how you are a goddess. Don't identify as female, I identify as a goddess. Really digging deep into some lovely feminine energy today. Whatever it is, reach your arms up overhead, coming into a nice full body stretch. Toes and fingers reaching towards the opposite sides of the room. Shoulder blades come down the back. Glutes tuck under. Engage the abdominals. Ribs are drawing down towards the hips. Full body stretch. Inhale, lengthen. On an exhale, we're going to bring our hands and our feet to the left side of the mat while the hips remain to the right. So you're going to create a banana shape pose. This is called Bananasana, which means banana pose. You should feel a nice side body stretch. If you want to, option to cross the right foot over the left ankle, deepening the side body stretch. Breathe deeply into your side. Try not to replace the tension anywhere else in the body. Melt the shoulders into the floor. Inhale back to center and switch sides as you exhale. I won't talk as much this time. Hold for three breaths. Back to center. We're going to come into a double wind relieving pose. So both knees come into your chest. And really try to rock and roll. See if you can tuck the pelvis under. Hold yourself in tight. Bring your soles of your feet to the floor. Arms out to a T. Early spinal twist. Shift the hips to the right. Lower the knees to the left. If that feels good, turn your gaze over your shoulder to the right. Opposite side. Shift the hips to the left, drop the knees to the right. If it's comfortable, gaze goes to the left. Turn to center and find a bridge pose. Soles of the feet to the ground, palms, the hands press into the floor. Inhale, on an exhale, we'll rise the hips towards the ceiling. Breathe here. Dig the heels into the floor. Pull the glutes up and forward. Inhale, lower, exhale, lift, lower, and lift, inhale, exhale, hold at the top, three pulses, see if you can get a little bit higher, and release to the floor. Last pose here, we're going to find a reclined pigeon. Or a figure four. So cross your ankle over your knee. Ooh. And you're going to reach through, capturing your thigh and drawing it towards you. We're looking for a stretch in the right hip. So if you want to grab onto your shin, I like to use my elbow to hook around here. Okay, switch sides. Oh. All right, we're gonna rock and roll up to a tabletop position. So come back to full wind relieving pose. We're just going to start to rock forward and back along the length of the spine. In your own time, come up to seated and find a tabletop. Root the hands into the floor. We're going to find some cat-cow action. Back to neutral. We'll find a thread the needle. Into a child pose. Shift forward into Sphinx. Crocodile pose. Pectoral stretch. Switch to the other side. Oh, thank you. You get into the other. Cool. Sideline sweeps. Looking for a sensation in the side body. If you don't feel anything here, push up onto the hand until you do. Oh. Okay, other side. Side leg, side stretch. Push up onto the hand if you want. Okay, back to center. We're going to come up onto a side plank on the knees or on your feet. You want to come up onto your knees. You're going to come up like this. Make sure that your shoulder and wrist are perpendicular to the floor. If you want to come up onto your feet, this is an option. Hold here and breathe. Another option is to lower to supported side plank, which is the next one for me. And switch sides. So options are side plank on the knees, full side plank. Asistasana, yeah. Or supported side plank. For some reason. Okay. And coming into plank pose. But first, let's take chows.
Catch your breath.
Moving into plank. You can be on your knees or on your toes, preparing for the more active part of class. Standing, flowing. From here, we're going to push into a downward facing dog. Walk your dog. Return to your intention. Walk your feet towards the front of the mat, towards your hands, and come into a forward fold at the top of your mat. Clasp the elbows, find your ragdoll. Bend the knees and roll up to mountain pose or Tadasana. Arrive in standing. Inhale. Exhale, fold. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Exhale, step back to downward facing dog. Forward to plank. Lower to chaturanga. Find a baby cobra, halfway lift. Lower down. Back to downward facing dog. Three-legged dog, alternate. Hop to forward fold, halfway lift, fold, rise to stand, inhale, arms up overhead, and Sahasrara. One more round, inhale, exhale to fold, inhale, rise, exhale, fold, back to downward facing dog, exhale, forward to plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog or cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Hold in your down dog. All right, raise your right leg and scorpion tail. Open the hip. Let's find some knee circles. One. Two, three. Other side. Two, three. All right. Step or hop to the front of your mat. Inhale to rise. Exhale, fold. Inhale. Rise to mountain. Hands to heart center. Okay. Turn to the front of the room. Feet about double hip width. Toes are pointing out diagonally. Raise your arms up out to the side. Tuck your glutes under. Raise your arms up overhead. Inhale. On an exhale, we're going to cactus the arms and squat. Inhale, reach. Exhale, squat. Inhale and exhale. Two more at your own pace. Good. Point the toes forward and slowly, slowly, slowly lower down from the waist. Palms come to the floor first,
and then we lower the crown of the head, standing wide-legged forward fold.
If you want to, you can grab onto your ankles. Press the right palm into the ground, twist and open to the left. Hold here. Inhale to lengthen through the spine, exhale, twist. Back to center, switch sides. Back to center. We're going to walk the hands over to the right and hold. Towards the right, we're coming into a low lunge, runner's lunge, with the left leg back, right foot forward. Hold here. From here, step the front foot back, find a downward facing dog. Inhale forward, chaturanga, cobra up dog, downward facing dog. Step or hop to the front of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift, exhale to fold, inhale to rise. We're going to do those goddess squats again. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, squat. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. This time, hold. Raise your left heel. Lower. Raise the right heel. Lower. Left, right, left, right. Now try to raise both and hold. Good. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, forward fold. Whew. Grab onto the backs of the ankles. Whew. Maybe the crown of the head touches the floor. Good. Bring the palms of the hands to the floor. Press the right one into the ground. Raise the left. Switch. Good. Now, coming into, oh, right. Walking the hands over here. Turning into a runner's lunge on the left-hand side. Step back into a downward-facing dog. Vinyasa. Step back with the right leg. Coming into a high lunge. Hold here. Maybe find a cactus. Chest opener. Back bend. Inhale to reach up overhead. Transition into Virabhadrasana 3, Warrior 3. So root into the left foot and rise up with the back leg, lowering the torso, reaching forward, Warrior 3. From here, lower the hands to the floor, raise the right leg up behind you, standing split. Bring your feet together. Oh, there we go. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Step or hop back into a downward facing dog. Forward to plank. Lower to chaturanga. Inhale. Exhale to downward. Inhale, lift leg up. Exhale, forward. Rise up, high lunge. That's another way to get there. Actually, I guess we should be the opposite. There we go. All right. Arrive here in high lunge. Whew. Maybe find a little cactus arm back bend. Transition into Warrior 3. Take flight. Transition to standing split. Feet come together. Final vinyasa. Halfway lift, fold, step or hop back into down dog, forward to plank, flow, back to down dog. Okay. Whew. Step or hop to the front of the mat. This time, sink the hips towards the ground. Garland pose. I'm going to turn towards the camera. Beginning to transition to our floor work and cool down. Lower the right hand to the ground, open to the left. Maybe look up. Switch sides. Come to find a seated position. Cobbler's pose or bound angle, Baddha Konasana, also known as cobbler's, also known as butterfly. Come forward to whatever degree feels right for you. Bending from the waist before the head. Chandra Shashana, head to knee. Other side. And then boat pose. To staff pose, Dandasana, to forward fold. Okie dokie. Half Lord of the Fishes. Don't know the same two. Sides. Oh. We'll find happy baby, Ananda Balasa. Other side. Full wind relieving pose. Forward knees and relax. Intuition.